If you had the chance to travel by the airplane since September 11th, you are very well familiar with the TSA security procedures. Before you get to gate, you basically get to take off your clothes, your belt, your shoes, empty your pockets, leave your money, leave your passport, ticket, and walk almost naked through that metal detecting machine, just in order to get safely to the other side and find your gate eventually. These security proceedings at the airport remind me a little bit Jesus' instructions in today's gospel. He says, take nothing for the journey but a walking stick. No food, no sack, no money in your belts. However, wear sandals. Obviously, Jesus was more tolerant than TSA officers who made you take off your shoes. But it is interesting, isn't it, that Jesus' instructions to his apostles are so closely related to TSA security instructions as well. Empty your pockets, have no money, no sack, no food, nor even a bottle of water. Put all the liquids in small bottles, in a separate small bottles, and then go through. Perhaps Jesus and TSA have something in common. Perhaps by emptying our pockets, by getting rid of the luggage, of the money, of the possessions, even our shoes, we can move faster, we can be safer. When Jesus sends out his 12 apostles, he gives them power, he anoints them for a special mission. But first, they need to make sure that they are safe to proceed. Just like we, before we depart on our next plane, wherever we go, perhaps to Jerusalem or somewhere else, we need to make sure that we will get there safely, that we will get there in time. And so we do empty our pockets. We get rid of our food, water, and anything else that can stop us in our tracks. Our earthly possessions, our things, objects that we treasure, that we are attached to, can slow down our spiritual journey. Those possessions sometimes possess us. And so, before we become Jesus' disciples, before we go to teach, to give witness to God's love, we need to be free. We need to empty ourselves and make sure that things do not possess us. It is okay to possess things. It is not okay to be possessed by them. Your money, your security, your passport, your food, your comfort zone. For taking off your shoes is very uncomfortable. So your comfort zone, even that, can limit and slow you down. One cannot truly be the apostle of Jesus when one is possessed by her or his possessions, by her or his comfort zone. The next passage in the Gospel is also very interesting. Jesus says, wherever you enter a house, stay there until you leave. But if they don't welcome you, leave immediately and shake the dust off your feet. And I'm thinking of so many people who stay in unhealthy situations, who stay in unhealthy, unwelcome relationships, environments, and dare I say, churches. In my 13 years of priesthood, I have talked to so many people who have confessed to being abused by their spouses, sometimes by their parents, and unfortunately, many times by their priests, by their rabbis, by their ministers. They were made feel like second-class parishioners, like second-class citizens, that they do not belong in that place, in that faith community, in that family. And yet, they kept choosing to stay. I am not a psychologist, and I will not dare to venture why do we stay in situations, relationships, churches that are not healthy for us. But Jesus' advice is very clear. Go where you will be fed. Go where you will grow. Go where you will be welcome and appreciated. Don't stay in a place, don't stay in a situation, don't stay in a relationship, don't stay in a church that does not want you, that does not appreciate you. Find a family, find a relationship, find a church that will embrace you and that will grow with you. Those two beautiful lessons from today's Gospel are powerful. It's okay to have possessions, but it is not okay to be possessed by them. And the second lesson, find a place, find a relationship, find a church that welcomes you, that loves you, that journeys with you.